Hey, if you watched my video yesterday, you're already aware that my current EDC, my Dan Wesson 10mm long slide Bruin, is out of my carry rotation for a while. This has been my EDC for quite a while, but now I can't carry it. It's not because I don't like this gun. I fully intend to go back to this gun. But as I mentioned in my video last night, my puppy ate my holster. Now, I know a lot of people are like, oh, I think you did that, not your puppy. I think you turned into a werewolf and ate your holster. That's garbage. That's not what happened. My doggy ate my holster. I wouldn't eat my own holster. I'd have it on, actually, if I turned. So that happened. My holster got eaten, so now I have to choose another gun to carry temporarily until I can get another holster for this gun. And this was a prototype, so they don't offer this direct sale. And every other option I have for getting one of these holsters, or a holster similar to it, is a custom holster, which is going to take several weeks to get. So for a while, I'm going to have to carry something different. Yesterday, I did a video asking what did people think I should carry, and it really came down to two different options that are very dissimilar. So I'm going to go over them today and go over the pros and cons of the two, and then let you all vote on which one I'll carry. I'll put a poll in the upper corner of this video. You can actually click on and go over and vote for which one you want to carry. So let's go ahead and look at the two different guns and see what you think. My first option is one of my favorite guns that I own. I love this gun. I've been shooting it a lot. And it is my 9mm STI Staccato P2011. Absolutely love this gun. And I would be carrying this gun in another 1791 holster. I really like their holsters, and that's what I'd be carrying this in. As you can see here, it fits perfectly. It's like it was made for this gun. The only thing is, the holster is made for a 5-inch barrel, and this is a 4.25 inch barrel, so there's a little bit of extra at the end. That doesn't bother me so much. I can handle that. I just don't like barrels sticking out the bottom. That really bothers me. So this would be option number one, my 9mm STI Staccato P2011 in a 1791 holster. Okay, the next option we have is quite a bit different, like I said, and it is my Smith & Wesson 329 PD. This is a 6-shot, 44 Magnum pistol. It has a scandium frame and barrel shroud, stainless steel barrel, and titanium cylinder. The holster I would be carrying this in is my favorite custom holster maker, Lobo Holsters. I'd be carrying this in my Lobo custom holster here. Now, Lobo holsters are tight when you first get them, so I spent all night last night putting this gun in the holster and taking it out while watching television. I mean, I've holstered this thing so many times, I've worn the finish off the front to my sights, which I'll have to redo. But that's what I'd be carrying this gun in, my Lobo custom holster. All right, now that you've seen what they are and how I'll carry them, let's go over the pros and the cons of both guns. Pros for this gun is it has a red dot. Makes it easy for old eyes like mine to actually hit your target. That's definitely a pro. The other pro for this gun is it is the same manual of arms as my everyday carry. I mean, it is a 1911, operates just like a 1911, so I wouldn't be changing manual of arms at all. It'd be very similar with this gun, so that's definitely a pro. Now, the cons of this gun would be it's 9mm. It's not a caliber I like to carry. It's not a caliber I'm all that crazy about. It's a functional caliber, I guess, but, you know, what if I have to shoot at something like a bear? I mean, I live up in the woods, or what if I have to shoot at somebody that has, like, I don't know, a shirt and a t-shirt on? Or, heaven forbid, a light jacket. It is fall, you know. So that's the biggest downside of this gun. It is 9mm. That's really the only con I can think of for this gun, because it has great capacity. It holds 18 plus one rounds, so it's got plenty of ammo there. It's just that it's the wrong ammo. It's not the ammo I want. But like I said, it is a perfectly acceptable ammo as long as I don't actually have to shoot anybody. So those are the pros and cons of this gun. Now let's look at the pros and cons of the Smith & Wesson 329 PD. The biggest pro, it's a revolver, which means it's a superior gun in every way. Just love revolvers. Everyone knows to love revolvers. So that's its biggest pro. Its next biggest pro, which is just about as close as big a pro, is that it is 44 Magnum. It wouldn't matter what I had to shoot at with this gun. If I hit it with this gun, I'm going to do it some damage, be it bear or even a guy with a heavy coat on. So that's a big advantage to it. It's 44 Magnum. Now let's talk about the cons of this gun. Well, the biggest con about it is that it doesn't have as sophisticated a sight system as the STI. If you're going to have to shoot at something fast moving, and this is werewolf season, so you might have to shoot at something fast moving, you're going to be at a little disadvantage with this gun. So that's one disadvantage. It doesn't have as nice a sights. The other disadvantage is that it is a different manual of arms. But since it is a revolver, it's very simple. I don't think I'm going to get confused with either guns. They're both very simple. But still, it is a different manual of arms than my everyday carry. And another con, which some people might see as a con, is that it is lower capacity. This only holds 6 rounds, whereas the STI holds 19 rounds total. So that means this gun has less rounds. But they're 44 Magnum. And 44 Magnum is worth its weight in 9mm easily. So I really wouldn't consider that a big disadvantage, but some people might. So there's the pros and there's the cons of this gun. It's lower capacity. It doesn't have as nice a sights, but it is 44 Magnum and it is a superior gun. Okay, now that you've seen what the two options are and you've seen how I will carry them and we have discussed the pros and cons of both guns, which one would you say I should carry? Go to the link in the upper corner of this video, click it, vote in a poll, and let me know, if you were me, which one of these would you carry as your new temporary EDC?
Oops.
It's the lady at 46
South Rose.